this is not going to, mine is not going to be white enough.
It's interesting thinking about how much Emerson loves trains. It really relates back to our life and what we're going through, because there have been a lot of twists and turns and bumps and stops and delays, and we weren't sure what we were coming up on next. When Emerson came into our lives, I was really worried. He was so delicate, and that's the first time that I had really been in charge of something so fragile.
My favorite thing about Emerson is his love of life and his energy and his enthusiasm. I feel like Emerson was sent to our family for a reason.
He went to a birthday party and they had set up a train table on the side. And he loved it. He like wouldn't leave it alone. And on the way home from the party, we went to the store, bought him his first train set. I could see him learning. I could see him growing, like watching, like, okay, this part goes over here, and then this part goes over here. Emerson was happy and healthy, and everything that we heard a terrible two would be.
Ole, ole, ole.
Messy.
It started at the train table, where he would put his arms on the table and like lean really heavily on the table. And we'd ask him, you know, what's going on? And he'd say legs hurt or hurt to walk. We knew that something wasn't right. So we took him to a pediatrician. They said, you need to take him to ER right now. And so we took him down. And at that time, they just sent us home. They said, we're going to schedule you for a hematologist and you'll see them in a few weeks. At the blood specialist, it felt like something was really wrong. And a doctor sat us down and told us, your son has leukemia. We found cancer in his bones.
Nothing can prepare you for that news. I think as a parent, you always want the best for your kids. You want them to be happy, to be healthy. It was devastating for us.
Why would someone so small, someone so happy, someone so full of life be taken away from life? We had no time to prepare, no time to think. It was hard to feel happiness or hope or anything because it all happened so quickly. We thought, this must be advanced stage cancer. When we were faced with the idea that we wouldn't have our son for very long, each moment became precious to us, and we started focusing on just loving him every day, every hour, every time we were with him. We wanted to be a good memory.
What's a frog say?
Ribbit.
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 While at the hospital, he'd always want to be out, and he'd always want to be playing, and he was always very happy. He was really excited to share his love of trains with other people. I was amazed that he found joy in everything. He found joy in the nurses. He found joy in the playroom. He found joy being stuck in this hospital for weeks. Emerson taught me a lot about trials. It really put perspective in my life of why am I complaining about the things I complain about? I should be happier. I should be more grateful. I should slow down and take things a day at a time. I had to make this work because everything I loved depended upon it. And then when I got back to those people that depended on me, I just wished that I didn't have to leave. There were a lot of times where Emily and I would sit down and we'd figure out, this isn't gonna work. The Tyler Robinson Foundation gave me back control of my finances and of my time, so I didn't have to worry so much about living day to day, and I could spend time with Emerson, I could spend time with Emily, and spend time at home where it mattered. So we felt like they knew what it was like because of Tyler and because of everything that he went through.
We feel like they truly care about us and about our son.
Emerson was in intensive treatment for 10 months. after 4 months of treatment, we discovered that Emerson's body was reacting a lot better, that the treatments were going really well, and that the cancer wasn't detectable. We still needed to have treatments, but we had hope again. The first time we got to leave the hospital, he knew something was different because he wasn't plugged into his IV. And so he'd run through the hallways as fast as he could, and watching the doors open and seeing sunlight, everything was a big deal to him. He was so excited. Now we get to plan our future with him and enjoy the moments with him. We're not stuck in this mind frame of, we're gonna lose him. The Tyler Robinson Foundation, more than anything, has given us hope, has given us the peace to know that we can make it, that we'll be all right, that we can be a cancer family and still be happy.
Okay, Google, play Thunder by Imagine Dragons.
Okay, Thunder by Imagine Dragons. Here it is on Spotify.
Just a young gun with a quick fuse. I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my whole life behind.
I like not all the different colors.
Not a follow-up.
I like big trains and small trains.
I was lightning before the thunder.